smell it.
Mark Nash.
Michael Gross.
Michael Gross, the boss.
My nigga. My brother.
Let's get this done, Mike.
We all love sports, right?
Mike Ross, the boss, this is Mike on sports. He smoke competition, same time smoke a port. When it comes to debating, he's one of the greatest. Put him on the A-list, over Kellerman and Bayless. If you missed the show, couldn't make it, just log on and click the playlist. That boy always working, not to be played with. Hit subscribe and the bell for the latest. Mike Gross, the boss, Mike on sports. Right there from first bell, tip up and coin toss. Mike Gross, the boss, Mike on sports. He call it how he see it, either you won or you lost. Big games, big fights, rolling dubs up. You like the content, hater, click the thumbs up. Cash App, Super Chat, go all in. But do your research first before you call in.
I kind of want to change gears right now. Okay. I want to get your reaction to the news that Deontay Wilder came out with about a week and a half, two weeks ago, about the Mark Breeland. First, let's start with Mark Breeland, because you being a trainer, it's only right me start with a trainer. The reports say that Wilder felt like his water was tampered with, and he said he thinks, he didn't say for a conclusive, he said he thinks that Marlon, that Breeland could have something to like do with it. And he feels like Breeland not disobeyed him, but like broke a rule that he'd been instilling for the entirety of his partnership with Mark. Do not throw the towel in. Do not throw the towel in. And Breeland threw the towel in. Like, just what's your whole reaction to that trainer aspect first?
Okay, as far as like the, you know, tempering with my water and all that shit, I'm gonna throw that shit out the ring. I'm gonna throw that shit out, man. You know, you got to look at Mark. You got to look at his history, and I think Mark is probably one. You know, he's a good fucking trainer because he's an old fighter, and as far as, you know, that water shit, man, I can't see it, man. I fucking can't see it, man. You know what I'm saying? And then as far as you know, in the corner, throwing the towel in the corner, you know what I'm saying? He's looking out for the fighter. He's looking out for the fighter. And the fighter, of course, they want to go out on their shield. They want to go out on their shield. But the trainer, that's like me and Terrence. And if I see Terrence getting his ass kicked, man, the first thing I'm gonna start doing, I'm gonna start crawling like a motherfucker, like a little girl and shit in the corner and shit. My son getting his ass whooped and shit. So the first thing I wanna do, I wanna get in the ring, I wanna help you. But I gotta be the trainer. And you got the commissioners right there. So I gotta tell somebody, stop the motherfucker fight, man, because you ain't gonna let my mom, I ain't gonna keep letting my son get his ass whooped. You know what I'm saying? But, like we talked in the gym, when a time comes like this in the fight, you gotta give me that sign say to stop the fucking fight, man. You gotta give me that sign. And I don't care what it is. If you're looking at the corner, if you shake your hand or you turn your hand, that's something that we talked about first before the fight even started. That's something we talked about in the gym years and years and years and years. And then we get to that point, we know how to cross that bridge. Once we cross that bridge, then we're going to get it taken care of. But as far as the water and all that other shit, man, I'm going to throw that shit out, man. I won't believe it. I got my neighbor right here. I got my neighbor right here, Rob. Man,
what's good? What's good?
Yeah.
How you doing? How do you feel about Malik Scott?
Are you gonna say something to my neighbor, man? Damn.
I said what's up to him, man. You didn't hear me? I said what's up, bro. How you doing?
How you doing out here, man?
You're trying to stay on both that good side, man.
Yes,
sir,
man.
Shout out to y'all, man. Hey, man.
I'm sitting in the fucking driveway, bitch, on the interview with y'all, man. You know what I'm saying?
Hey, man. Real friends hard to find, man. I'm telling you, real friends hard to find.
All right. I'm sorry about that, y'all.
Now you good. How do you feel about Malik Scott possibly taking the reins and becoming, I guess, the lead trainer in Wilder's camp?
Well, you know, I don't know, man. You know what I'm saying? They must have ran into each other sometime in the camp, and then they must have a good rapport with each other or something like that, you know. But I mean, if Deontay Wilder is comfortable with him, and they're comfortable with each other, and they understand what the game is, and they understand everybody got to be on the same page when you go into the fight. That's fucking win. You know what I'm saying? It's fucking win. So if they on the same page and nothing else is involved, no narrative, no agenda is involved, they know what they doing. Deontay Wilder know what he doing.
Sometimes you gotta give people their flowers. While they can still smell them. Mark Nash, Michael Gross, the boss. My nigga. Let's get this shit done, Mike.
We all love sports, right?
Mike Ross, the boss, this is Mike on sports. He smoke competition, same time smoke a port. When it comes to debating, he's one of the greatest. Put him on the A-list, over Kellerman and Bayless. If you missed the show, couldn't make it, just log on and click the playlist. That boy always working, not to be played with. Hit subscribe and the bell for the latest. Mike Gross, the boss, Mike on sports. Right there from first bell, tip up and coin toss. Mike Gross, the boss, Mike on sports. He call it how he see it, either you won or you lost. Big games, big fights, rolling dubs up. You like the content, hater, click the thumbs up. Cash App, Super Chat, go all in. But do your research first before you call in.